Here's something you don't see every day anymore. It is a Packard Bell electronic typewriter, model PB10TX. I found this at the thrift store recently. And it has the original cover over the keyboard, but unfortunately the clips that hold it on are broken off. Which must have happened when it was on the shelf, because if it was broken when the thrift store got it, they would have just taken it off and thrown it out. And I know how it happened too. On most typewriters, or at least the ones I've used, with a cover over the keyboard, the way you remove them is you slide them off the front. But this one, you're supposed to lift it up, because if you just try to yank it off the front, that's how you break those clips. So I can understand how those things broke. But at least it still has it. So taking off that cover reveals the keyboard. And since this is an electronic typewriter, the keys don't have any kind of mechanical connection to what comes out of the printing mechanism. What it essentially is a computer, except it only has a very limited function of taking whatever you type on the keyboard and sending it to the printer. Because this is actually a daisy wheel printer. And they did sell computer printers that were based on the same kind of mechanism as this. If we took off the ribbon and released this mechanism, we can actually see the daisy wheel. And they call it that because each letter is on a little petal, just like the petals of a flower. So each character that this typewriter can type is on one of these little things here. And when you type a letter, it moves that particular character to the position where this hammer can strike it against the ribbon and onto the paper. And you can actually change these daisy wheels to get different fonts. So we just clip that back into place. And here you can see the correcting ribbon. You can actually see some of the characters that have been corrected. This is known as a liftoff correction tape because this ribbon doesn't type in ink, it types in carbon particles. And what it does is this correcting ribbon has a sticky substance on it which adheres to those carbon particles and lifts them off of the paper. That doesn't always work perfectly, but it usually works pretty well if you correct something that you just typed. So that's the correcting ribbon, and it looks like it's about halfway used up because this side, the take-up reel, has about the same amount of tape on it as the supply reel. And there's the carbon ribbon. You can see some of the letters that are typed, and that's the security threat of these typewriters. If you pull out this ribbon, you can see everything that somebody has ever typed on it. You won't see the spaces, but you'll see the words, so you can probably still make out what somebody was typing. And that just snaps back into place. And this is the little guide that goes against the paper. And this is the knob to advance your paper. Some of the fancier typewriters have a motorized platen, so they don't even have knobs on the sides. You just push a key on the keyboard to move it. But this one is more basic, so you get these knobs. And I think you should be able to take out this roller in case you get something stuck inside it, like a label. So now we can close that lid again. And here's that keyboard. You can see it has a number of special characters on it that you don't normally get on a computer keyboard, like a half and a quarter symbols, and plus and minus, and the British pound symbol, and a cent sign. So it does have some special characters. And there's special functions here. You can say to type the letters either stronger for things like multi-part forms, or lighter force for thin paper, so you don't tear through it. And then you get different line spacing, either single-spaced, one-and-a-half-spaced, or double-spaced lines. There's 10 or 12 characters per inch pitch, and you can do an auto-centering, which I think you type in a complete line, and then when you press return, it automatically centers it and types it out. So it does have a little bit of memory, although this is not a word processor, so it's limited to probably just one line of memory. And auto-carriage return, I think, is when you type a space in the last little part here, it'll automatically return and go to the next line. Because unlike a word processor, normally, once you get to the end of a line, it will not automatically go to the next line. You have to hit return. And here's the paper guide. and it can show you as marks to show you where to line up the edge of different sizes of paper, like 8.5 inch paper, which is the size we use in the USA, and A4 paper, which is the European size, and other things like that. On the back is the label, made in Korea, and here is the compartment for storing the power cord. So we just unsnap that and it swings down, and here is our power cord, which we can guide through one of those cutouts so we can close that back up when we have it plugged in. And thankfully the tabs that hold the power cord compartment closed are not broken. And on this side we got our on-off switch, and on the bottom is the carrying handle, and that's about it. And I realize my older viewers are probably wondering why I'm going into so much detail on how a typewriter works and how to use it. That's because I'm pretty sure a lot of my younger viewers have never actually used a typewriter or seen one up close. They've probably only ever seen one in a movie or an old TV show. So for the younger generation, this is how you use a typewriter. You put in your paper, you line it up with the mark showing where to line it up, and you lift up this guide here, and then once it's up to about that high, you put the guide back down, and you just gotta make sure your paper is straight, because sometimes it goes in a little crooked. So that's pretty good. And when you have that all set up, you can turn it on. It does its little dance while it initializes everything. And now it's ready to type. So now, whatever we type on the keyboard shows up on the paper. And I just made a mistake, so I hit the correction key. I'll show that up close later, but it just lifted off those incorrect letters off the paper, so now I can type the right letters. And I just ran out of space to type because I reached the end, and you heard those beeps. The first beep warns you that you're running out of space at the end of the line, and the second beep means you've reached the end. But I think I can do a margin release. Let me see if I can do that. If you do a margin release, it usually lets you type a little bit more. So if you really don't want to erase that last word you typed, you can release the margin and squeeze it in, which I was able to do there. And you hit return, it goes to the next line. So we can type some more stuff here. And there you can see what I just typed on the paper, and you barely can just see where I typed the second J on the word jumped, and you can see where it lifted it off. There's a little bit of trace of it left, but it's not too bad. So I'll show you that correction feature. Okay, now I'm gonna erase. See how it lifts the letter off the paper? I think it types it like 3 times on the correction ribbon to get all of it off, or at least most of it. And I think if you hold down code while you hit the correction key, you see it says word. I think then it does an entire word at one time. Now I'll show the different character spacing. This was being typed at 10 characters per inch. Now I'll change it to 12 characters per inch. Okay, that was 12 characters per inch. Now I'll change it back to 10. So there you can see the difference. The 12 characters per inch makes the letters a little closer together, and the 10 characters per inch makes them a little more spaced out. You can see some of the letters are not coming out exactly right. It's probably because the ribbon is probably 20 years old, so it could stand to have a new ribbon in there. And just notice you can do half space. And it also has shift lock, which is not like a caps lock on a computer, because it also shifts the numbers and the special characters. So if I have shift locked on and I type numbers, it comes out with symbols. And you can also set up tabs. And the BS key is a backspace, but it does not correct whatever you typed. So for example, if we want to type a zero with a slash through it, like you might see in some computer manuals, what you do is you type a zero and hit backspace and then you type a slash. And that gives you your zero with a slash through it. So you can combine characters on top of each other. Those are some of those symbols you don't normally get on a computer keyboard, which this can type. And if you want to remove your paper quickly without rolling it all the way up, what you do is you release the roller pressure, and then you can just yank it out. And there is our wonderful typed document. And in case you're wondering, yes, it is still possible to buy new typewriters today. I know Brother is still selling typewriters, and there's a company based here in New Jersey called Swintech, which also makes and sells typewriters. And I've even seen mechanical typewriters. Those were the ones which don't use any electricity, and the pressure of you hitting the key is what strikes the letter on the paper. I've seen one of those in the Sharper Image catalog for $200 that says Royal on it, although I don't know if Royal is actually the one making them. I think they just put their name on it. So that is the Packard Bell PB10TX electronic typewriter, probably from the late 1980s. So now we can turn it off, close the cover, put the keyboard cover on it. And once you put that power cord back in its compartment, you're ready to flip out the handle and carry it wherever you need it to go. So it's designed to be portable. And here's a Packard Bell advertisement from the late 1980s showing the products they sold at that time, including desktop computers, tower computers, laptops, laser printers, and there's that same model of typewriter that I just showed you. So I don't know if they ever had any other models of typewriters, but this is the one that they showed in their ad, and it's the one I have.